Hello there, and welcome to my humble little channel, and what I certainly do not expect to be a full playthrough, but nevertheless, of a classic game called Unreal. You may have heard of it. This is from 1998. It occurred to me that that's 20 years ago, and I feel like such a terrible relic saying that, because I was actually around back then. And certainly in the capacity I actually use a keyboard and a mouse, so jolly good. What I'm going to show you is basically taking a tour of the sights and sounds of this lovely old gem. But first for some minutia of the gaming world, what you had to do back then. Preferences of the game. Principally, note the resolution. This is what I had to choose to make the game jive with proportion of monitor and the recording software, which is what we call 720p today. Back in the day, you actually read out the entire proportion of the both X and Y axes. Now, the very best that the game had to offer was this 1600x1024. There was no such thing as 1080p back then. That only arrived with the, well, advent of HD video and the HD DVD and Blu-rays. And if you actually had a monitor that could drive this resolution, you were quite well off. You had the fat wallet out when you were buying your PC hardware. That's for certain. Also, if you wanted to actually run a game at this resolution, you'd need a quite beefy graphics card. At the other end, 640x480, today known as 480p, which was a very button of 3D accelerator that allowed you to run a game at anything that really. I started with, I believe it was 1996, something called Voodoo. And they kickstarted the 3D gaming market, more or less. And somebody called ATI jumped on, and somebody called NVIDIA, and so on. And also another video driver, Direct3D. That was a rather new thing when Microsoft discovered that they actually ought to support these 3D video cards, and not just sit on the sidelines while the Voodoo hardware was using Glide drivers, ATI was using their own drivers, and NVIDIA was using whatever they called it back then, which was basically one big fray that was about to, certainly confuse the consumers. Just look at this. Use dynamic lighting. Dynamic lighting was a thing back then. It wasn't until, again, NVIDIA tossed out something onto the market called the GeForce, which had an engine called TNL. Transforming lighting. Lighting. Nonsense. Lighting. Before that, that was not something the 3D graphics hardware would be able to handle, or still something that the CPU handled. And thus, I should note, before the 3D rendering hardware, it was the CPU that did all of the heavy lifting. It's called software rendering, where the CPU basically tossed the data into a chunk of memory called the frame buffer, which then, for a certain number of times each second, tossed it down the line to the monitor, and lo and behold, it became an image on the screen. And if it did fast enough, you could actually have an enjoyable game. So let's just pass through the network for great entertainment. Yeah, you had something called a modem backer. That's when you actually had to dial into an internet service provider to get onto the internet. That's a process that typically took 30 seconds, and it wasn't even certain to succeed. Sometimes you just get dropped off due to bad line conditions or, well, the position of the moon relative to your modem or whatever. And then, yeah, well, some telephone companies, they also, they charge you for each attempt at calling, so if it failed, yeah, money out of your pocket. ISDN, most people don't know what that is, and the others, you do know. But certainly, that was before the age of ADSL. Oh dear heavens. AGD yada yada yada. Let's get on with it, and I will try not to talk all the time, because even though I'd very much like to share the nostalgia, it will break the immersion, and I do want you to get a sense of how that was. So, here we go. And I'm not going to go with a hard moan, because I don't want this to be a Wild West shooter where I'll waste lots of time and patience on your part. I just want to tell you a story, show you sights and sounds. Let's go. Oh.
Prisoners 849 escaping.
Bandages only slightly used. Oh, that they need to work on the sanitary conditions here. Oh.
All prisoners remain yourselves.
Prisoners. Cells. Oh, I'm in the prison. Jolly good. Translator. Busy for reading out all the little messages. Attention all prisoners, lights out tonight. Oh dear. Oh dear. Okay. That was unexpected. But that certainly shows the dangers of a prison environment. Shall I try again? So how to actually... Oh, poor lady. Here we go again. I hadn't planned that on happening, trust me.
Prisoners 849 escaping.
Guy over here. Poor fellow. Structural integrity isn't too good. I better get out of here. And again, the sanitary conditions. Let me be able to call the plumber. Ouch. It seems this guy was impaled by a support beam. Gershwin's diary, day 204. There was another roach in my lunch today. Yeah, it's good for you boy eating this protein. I wonder how they make on board starships such as this one. If that bitch in cell 4A keeps looking at me funny, I swear I'm gonna rip out her living. That wouldn't be me, would it? I am, however, such equipped. Alright. Public information terminal, yada yada yada. Be kind to your cellmate, violence will not be tolerated. Yes sir. Right. What's this? Dynamite? No, it's a flare. I suppose that may come in handy. Dark places all that. Boys, Clegg's Diary, Day 3. There's a new guy. I've been here for 3 days and already have 2 cracked ribs, fractured thigh, and 14 stitches. I don't know if I'll make it to the prison moon. Prison moon? Much less to the end of next week. Prison moon, we're in a prison freighter, oh dear. How did I get here? I don't remember that. Oh well. Lots of screaming, as you may hear. And I'll start out with, well, it's not a spoiler, but it's certainly showing off a little secret that's certainly not obvious to whoever's starting the game. Yes, of course, there's no weapons here, but there is a slightly gruesome thing. Being a prison ship for very nasty, violent criminals, there's also a facility for disposing of the ones that haven't been behaving. What's this then? Oh dear.
Security breaches detected.
Well, that's one less mouth to feed, I suppose. Okay, you could only do it once, but... And, of course, with the, oh dear. I don't actually have to press the action button, just run into the lever. Okay, let's get out of here. And, at this point, just take in the experience, because this, what you're about to see, was epic back in the day.
Prisoner 327 escaping. You have entered a restricted area.
Vortex Writer, the prisoners have become more and more restless as we get closer to the prisoners. Security says the prisoner is under control, but several have had to be taken to the med lab for treatment. I'd expect they say med bay, but I can't rule out that they actually do an experiment on them. It occurs to me. Captain Mark, escort Vortex Writers. Altering our course may have proven detrimental to our mission. We are caught in the gravitational field of an uncharted planet. I've ordered the engine foreman to divert power to the drives. Oh god. That guy was actually alive. Navigator aboard, Vortex Writers. We are en route to the prison moon. Long-range sensors are detecting uncharted magnetic masses and gamma sector 83H. Captain has ordered a change in course. I smell something brewing.
Security.
I don't think I'm getting that. Oh, actually, I am. Yeah, better put on something. Can't run around naked. Well, I suppose I could, but it's rather unseemly. Chief Medical Officer's log. Prison vessel 254. Vortex Rikers. Constant fighting between prisoners seems to be getting worse. At this rate, I'll be out of supplies long before they reach the prison moon. That ain't too good. Actually, that's very bad. They've been in quite a scrap. Oh yeah. You couldn't take it.
You have entered a restricted area.
Where we are, but they mentioned the planet. This looks like we're, well, maybe not in for a collision. Maybe we've already crashed. Oh, heavens. Poor fella. Engine foreman's log, prison vessel 254, Vortex Rikers. I'm chasing off all the power I can to escape from the gravity on board this planet. It doesn't seem to be working. Oh damn. Oh, I thought it was a bandage. No, never mind. I don't need that. Security guards log, present vessel 254, Vortex Risers. They pulled all power to the drives to no effect with spirit towards the planet. I don't know what's going to happen to us. I suppose I do. Situation is critical. Last night, large, extremely powerful agent forces penetrated our camp. Fire small missiles from hand launchers. We lost 5 men. So we crashed for more than 12 hours. I've been knocked out for 12 hours. Damn, piranhas. Get me out of here. Back when you actually had to balance on a razor's edge. The house. Cook! No reply to distress signal. Vortex Riders fall is too unstable to use as a shelter. We found an abandoned house used as our base camp. Maybe the native population can help us. This planet has a native population. Civilized, I guess, from the equivalent of those houses. Aha, and boss. I suppose that's influenced by the name of the musician for this game. His call was, last name was Van den Bos. As you can hear, this music is bloody awesome. Seen a Scarch vessel in operation. I mean, may need to gain control of this to escape the system. So, well, at least two ships crashed on this planet. It has a local population indigenous to it. There's some nastiness called the Scarch. It wouldn't just happen to be the one that slaughtered everybody aboard the ship now, would it? Hello, loot crates! Oh. That. Now, beautiful. Note that. Two songs. Prison colony, we crashed in the godforsaken golden rock. It sucks. Yeah, it does. Got it in me. Also, I suppose these lifts will actually kill you if you stand up. I'm going to test that out while it is. Indestructible. Ah, of course. Armor 200. Compass me there. Flying beast and uses his tail as a weapon. I was able to kill it, but not without taking a beating. I discovered the orange berries have a healing effect on me. I feel strong enough to proceed. Well, not far. So yeah, that fella, eh? Let me just have a brief friendly chat. Oh. Hello, little fella. Yeah, that's nice. It's like a cross between a rabbit and a horse. Two legs and it sounds like a bird. This is an alien planet after all. Oh, I have a bad feeling about that place. I should do some more petting the local fauna. Oof. Oh damn. Mind your half-life of it? Die. Oh, alternate firing mode. Maximum of 200. Explore the other part down there. Did I? No, I did not. Come on now. The audience is waiting. Oh, I just can't get enough of this, this is so marvelous. What do I get down there? Now the thing is, this game, I believe I ran into it some September afternoon in a nondescript PC store somewhere in the bleak town of Copenhagen. No, not the one in New York State. And together with a friend, we treated to the intro I showed you just earlier. That was breathtaking. It was shockingly good by today's standards. It's obviously rather simple. Something you'd take for granted. Actually, well, you know, it wouldn't be impressive if a game had done that. But back in the day, wow. Yeah. Just a few moments of start of the game. Very profound power of, well, taking you in, because that was so very new. Even the good games like Doom 2, well, it was a good shooter, but it simply didn't have atmosphere like what this provided. Oh. I blew a hole in the wall. Oh yeah. You can actually double jump. Or rather double. Ah, too bad it's not working very well. Come on. Not very impressive, is this? Better. Came here to die. Harabit village is on the other side of these mountains. I'm waiting for the two suns to set and proceed through the Rajagam mine. The only way. Oh dear. Humanoid but not human. Must be one of the natives. And these crystals. Chat. Power source 2 status as an actor, security gun position 2. Oh. I have that very nice. Got him! Barely scratch. Sure about. Look at that. Almost 300 armor. I'm a happy camper. Shots. I don't know. I got him. Come along. Hey, what are you doing? Oh! How nice. Save the room, sir. Save this guy. And get a reward. Earth equivalent of a minigun. So this terrarium seems to have a special significance in the game, other than being minigun ammo. Well, that's also quite significant in itself. What if I shoot a game without a minigun? Could it be? Oh, really? Very quick.
Oh!
Oh, dear heaven. In this game. I think this is a good place to use it. Let's see what this does. That's one. That's two. Three. And thank you. yes, I know I'm not playing on a very racing style. I haven't touched this in years. And besides, it does go to show a bit more how new and unexplored and outright overwhelming this game was. There's a shield belt here. So that was very much Terra Incognita. Oh, Incognita, I think. Oh dear. Use a weapon that has the most ammo available, especially if it's near to the ground. Oh, oh. I can. I can do that. Oh, it's a brood. Yeah, the big fun ones are called broods. The other ones are just scarred. I suppose the broods are some sort of mercenaries. Guessing this is a human computer system. Yeah, okay, I get it. You're a slave, but you know, I'm not your master. That's scotch. Oh, oh my god! I'm a man! Oh. Train carriages. Oh, go, 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 go. Yeah, oh my god, oh my god. So yeah, I don't want to detonate that bell. Move it. Oh, come on, move it. Move it. I don't want to blow it to smithereens. Come on. Where you go? Go, 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 go. You can imagine why that would be a bit frustrating in the end. Okay. Yeah. And of course it flies on the giblets instantly. Yeah, okay, yeah. I get it, I'm a daisy. Oh. Yet anyway. Oh hell. See, this is so old-school gamer-like. I mean, balancing on a beam of wood over a lava pool, a decrepit bridge, and there's a clip of ammo on the top of it. And there's a shield. Thank you. Made my day. Let's see. Hi there. guys have we got in quite a monotony? What the? Oh! Right. Most wonderful. I think this is a fitting place to stop, and